Well, this is a Fender 12 string, classic design, it says. If you look right there in the cover, it says classic design by Fender. It's really a nice guitar. It came in really perfect condition from Amazon. And I'm going to, in keeping with my policy, is never leave a guitar the way you got it. We're clearly going to do some things to this. One of the first things I'm going to do is change. I'm not going to change the whole tuner. I'm just going to change the ends, the tuning peg part, to blacks. I bought some of them online and they just came in today. I got two different styles. I may mix them, put one of each, every other. Because these 12-string guitars tuned an octave apart from each string. So I thought I might designate with that, or I may go with the bigger buttons, because these are pretty good sized buttons that are on here already. And then we're going to do the fingerboard with some inlays to go down the whole length of the fingerboard. I'm going to see if I got black pegs and change all the pegs to black also. And we'll also obviously go away with the chrome and go to black guitar strap buttons on the end. So we're going to get ready to do that stuff now. All right, the first thing we're going to do is take the pegs off and change some of them, because that's the easiest part of this job, I think. But we may be in for trouble. You never know. All right, I wasn't sure if my screwdriver was going to fit, so I did a test drive. So what we're going to do is just take the screw out that holds these heads on and try to lift it straight up. And they should, theoretically, just lift straight off. And it does. Now, it's got a black washer on there. And the ones that came with the other one are not black. Oh, don't tell me they ain't going to fit. Oh, that's going to be a heartbreaker. Seems to have a different shape on the inside. Oh, bummer. I took the ring off and the black washer off and the other washer off. Does that make any difference? Nope. These aren't going to fit. So this may be the end of this part of this project right away. Because these are round and this is square. Of course they're different. Who'd have thunk it? I don't know if this smaller one is different. No, it don't fit either. I don't think. Trying it both ways. And it's a different shape. Or it's a different size shape. Unbelievable. Never ever does anything ever work out when you try to do something. Unreal. It's a different shape. This one's round. The other one. This is a square set piece. You'd have to change the whole tuner. I'll be damned. I never dreamed that that would be an issue. But I can't do this either. So this is two projects in a row I've had screwed up by technicalities. Let me take a look at my supplies and see if I got anything.
Okay, so here we sit, brokenhearted.
These tuners have a different fitting. Oh, the pegs, I mean. These are round or a different size, and the original ones that came on this are kind of slotted. It's an elongated shape, so I can't do what I wanted to do with these. So all I can do is put these back on. I got to put the washers back on, and then we'll put the head back on.
and called this part of the makeover your basic flop. I don't know where the heck this one goes. It's got to go down below because there is nowhere else for it to go. There it goes. Okay. So now we've got to put the tuner back on, and then we've got to put the screw back in the hole. We were hoping to do the ebony and ivory thing again, but I can't. All right, so we've got to move on to phase two of the makeover, which brings us back to the fingerboard. All right, so those are on good and tight again now. They're nice tuners. I don't have anything against them. I just wanted to change the heads and do something a little bit more stylish. But I can't. So you can't do what you can't do. So we'll put them away. I got a bunch of other stuff out here. We'll change the pegs. I got six that are all black, and I got six with white dots. And we'll do that, and then we'll do the fingerboard. I just got to loosen the strings and get around to that. Okay, bye now.
Okay, after getting our heart broken there with not being able to change the keys to blacks, the next thing we'll do is work on the fingerboard and change that over and dress it up a little bit just for the heck of it. And I still may do the pegs down the bottom in black just because it's a quieter tone. I'm very disappointed I couldn't do that the way I wanted. Heartbreaking. Okay, just another heartbreak. So we'll get ready to do this. Take the tension off all the strings. We're not going to take them off because we don't need to. Why make more work for yourself than you have to? And we're not going to change the strings on the 12 because I don't have another set of 12 strings. So we'll bring that tension down, then we'll pull the strings back out of the way. And we'll do the fingerboard because that's all we can do. We'll dress it. We'll dress it for Patty with the hummies. I miss Patty. She was my favorite critic. Most of the time she was right. Now I gotta rely on my own judgment alone. Nothing right all about. Anyway, so we'll finish taking these guys down. Listening to a little Johnny Cash in the background. He was a hell of a guy. He lived his life on his own terms. Which again, maybe not be that good. But it was what it was. Pretty thrilling watching me spin the dials, huh? I'll be back in a minute. This little trick I came up with to tie the strings, pull the strings back out of the way, just a twist tie, makes it easier to get them out of the way and hold them down. I like to think I invented this, but I probably didn't. There's probably been a million guys who did the same thing before me. I'm not a genius. I'm just a willing participant in life. So we'll clean this up. I gotta go get a better rag to clean the fretboard up. And we'll clean it up. What we're doing is wiping down the fretboard to get any oil and stuff there may be, and to make these as smooth and clean as we can, so that the sticky inlays will sit on here well. Fairly clean. It does feel a little bit sticky, I don't know.
But I'm not going to mess with that at all. I just don't feel like it. All right, so we may do the hummy. I'll put a hummy up here. You can't see that, can you? Let's come down here and we'll show you what we may do on the body. I may put a hummy on the body. It's covered up down there. There's not really room to get it on there. Unless I get down below. Maybe I'll do it that way. It's kind of upside down, but it fits better that way. So we may do that on the body. I don't know. And then we've got a matching set of hummy stuff to go up the fingerboard here. Shania going in the background here. I think that'll lay on there pretty cute. Actually, look nice. And then we'll do the fingerboard with these guys. There's a diagram. Exciting to watch too, huh? So that's that. And the way this is going to lay, it's going to start up top here and work its way down. Oh, this is the top. This is the bottom. This is the starter side. And then this comes down here. I had it wrong. 12th fret, which is right here. So we build the hummy from there and then work our way up and down. So maybe we'll start there and do there. Okay, that's the 12th. That's going to cover that one. Here's my straight scissors. I'm not so sure for sure. Open up the door. Now what we should do, and we will do, is we'll get our Alice pick. The Alice is a stiff pick. You're just going to press these things onto the top of the tape here for the transfer process to get them to stick good there. So we're going to start at the 12th, which is a little different than I usually do. I usually start at the top and work my way down. But I'm going to cut these off close. So there's the hummy at the 12. We'll cut the edge off so we can get it real close to the fret. And then we'll cut the 11th the same way. That's going to go here. You got the hummy in the wings. And then we'll take this top part and trim it down close. And that's going to go there. So let's do these first three pieces and get an idea of what this is going to look like. I think these are going to look pretty good. And it really is nice for the folk guitar, 12-string folk guitar, to play with a natural background. Cool. These fit real well. These, I believe, are Giacomo's also. Are they? I think they're Giacomo. He's very modest. Anyway. Whatever they are, they're very nice. All right, and then we got this last of the three to go on here. That's peeling away pretty good. It's giving me a little bit of a hard time on this end. James Taylor playing in the background here. Come on, lift. It's not lifting easily off of this side. It's fighting me. Here it comes. Okay, so now we want to lay this down careful and line it up good. I'll take that edge off. Back to get my scissors. Oh. Put them right down where I can see them. Not. Alright, so anyway, you get the idea of where we're going here now. And I'm going to lay this one down, and then I'll turn off the camera and finish it up and get back to you. Alright, we'll do this one. Good. Oh, nice. That's good. Now where's Alice? We've got to put Alice back to work. Smoothing these things down so that now, instead of sticking to the top, we want it to stick to the fingerboard. So we'll do this to rub it in so it'll stay when we peel away. You get me? I need my pin. I use a push pin as a helper here to get edges. And then we'll pull it straight across. That sticks pretty doggone good, and we'll bring this flat across. And that'll stick pretty good too. Then we'll go after this one. Everything, oop. Sure, right when you open your mouth about how good everything's going, it crashes right before your very eyes. So we need to put this piece down. Geez, it was going good right up until now. That's pretty good. It's the enemy of good, better. It's good enough. And it'll work, and then we'll roll this last one back. All right, then we can see what it looks like with the Hummy on board, which was what we were trying to show you. And then we'll smooth this down with a little bit of Alice pressure. Looks good. All right, there's Hummy starting out. Nice. So we'll be back and we'll do the rest.
Okay, we've got everything applied. We're going to give him a rub down with Alice just to make sure everything will stick real good. And then we'll peel away the tops and we'll be all set. And that'll be it. It's looking pretty good, I think. Those are already peeled. That's the main one with the Hummy. We'll rub these down. We'll peel them away. And I'll show you the final. Okay? So we're going to peel up and roll over. Nice and flat. Get that to stay down. We'll give all these a good rub when we're done here, too. Straight across. Looks good. It's looking good. These guys are lifting a little, but they're staying in place, and we'll rub them down with Alice and get them to comply the way we want. Okay, so I'll be back in a minute. I'll show you the finish. All right, so we're rubbing everything down now with the Alice, the stiff pick, to make sure the decals stick on here really good. Stick on here really good. And they are. They're pretty good. And then we'll come back in a minute. We'll get all the strings on. We'll untie the magic holder. Pull that out. Put it back in the box. And then we'll lift the strings all back up and try to get them all reset. So I'll straighten the strings all out. Which isn't necessarily going to be simple. All right, so I'll be right back. Okay, now we got it all done here. We got it strung back up again. The strings are looking good. The fingerboard looks really nice. I like this. I think that looks really good. And then we're going to do the body with this Hummy. I'm going to trim this out a little bit and figure its placement a little bit better than what it is right there right now, and find a nice place for that to be. And this guitar, the 12-string Folk Fender Classic, is going to be done up in honor of Patty, because she loved the Hummingbirds. So this is kind of a tribute guitar. So what we'll do is we're going to trim this close so I can get it laid in and see where I want it to sit. The adhesive is not in the top of this, it's in the actual inlays themselves. So you don't have to worry about what you're trimming off, other than just to make it a closer look at the reality of the placement for where you want to put it. All right, well, I've cut down that inlay, and I think I'm going to place it there. I was thinking about maybe placing it up here. There's just barely room, and it would fit. I don't know. I got mixed feelings. And then I've got this for the headstock decal that I'm going to place up this end. Right there, somewhere like that. Just to dress it up some. Well, maybe I could do that over there and dress that up that way, but I think it'll be better as a headstock decal, so I think that's what I'm going to do. So that's the next two things we're up to here. We're up to no good today. Not being a nice guy. All right, so let's take this and see if we can rub it down with an Alice. I know you can't see me, but you just got to take my word for it that that's what I'm doing. And then we'll peel away the backing. Let's see if we can get this ready to lay it down as best we can. Now, once it touches, it's like game over. So it did touch. So wherever it landed is where it now is. So that's on. We'll rub it down. I think that's kind of pretty and will look pretty nice. It's a nice rose. So we'll get our special. Let's see if we can get the light on here. Yeah. A little bit of light, you can see a little bit better, and so can I. Now let's take and peel this up and see if we can peel this back without losing the decal. I lost a piece because I peeled too quick. You can't rush this stuff. Is that staying down or is it coming back? Staying down. So we're going to continue to unfold slowly, carefully, easily. And that's down. Pretty good. That all sat pretty good. Now we'll take Alice and give it another rub. Geez, it looks like the lettering in the fender decal or Fender logo. Looks good. Let's take a close-up. Let you get a good peek. That's pretty good. So the next thing we're going to do is move down here and put this on the body of the guitar. And I think I'm going to put it here by the hole. So we'll give this a rub to make it stick to the front. Oops. Everything.
Thing's kind of peeling away. It's not sticking to the... Oh. It's sticking where it's supposed to. I'm just stupid. Alright, that's going good. I forgot that it's not supposed to stick to the backing. It's supposed to stick to the tape. And that's what it did. So now we got to be very careful. The dog's barking to come in. I got to get Holly in a second. So let's try to keep this off the round hole. Uh-oh, I'm right at the edge. I'm right on the cusp. But like I said, once you put it down, it's down. So let me take a break for a second. I'll go get the dog and bring Holly. Okay, we're back to work. The dog's in. We're going to peel away this sticky stuff and see if this will stick well to the guitar. Oops. It was a little too aggressive. I can see another place here. There it is. Because these are pretty fine pieces that are here. And you can't yank them too hard, too quick. Well, you make them come off. That's where the little push pin comes in handy. Let's see if we can get this up without losing it. Need like six fingers. This is coming up over here, so I gotta put that back and bring this up from another way and see if we can do it. And come around the corner at it from over here and leave this in, lay down. Because we're getting to the critical part here now. And I don't want to lose my hummy. I think you got a good camera angle. Whew. We pulled it off. Now, we've got to get Alice to work again. And flatten some of this stuff down nice and smooth. I'm sorry this is so close to the edge. It could come up and be a problem as time goes by. The hummingbird's kind of flying upside down, but that's okay. Hummingbirds go in a lot of different directions. And it puts it in a nice location. But it's just, it's kind of in the wrong direction, the way they set up the decal. But it's what it is. It looks pretty good. So I like that. So that's that. So, that's the headstock. There's a close-up of that decal. That come out pretty good. The only thing I don't like is it's so close on this edge. But perhaps it'll be okay. Or perhaps it won't. If it starts to peel up, then what I'll do is take a little blade and cut some of it off and get it back into the body. There's the cute little hummy, and there's the fingerboard done all the way up, and the new headstock design. Pretty good. So I'm going to tune it up and I'll play a little song just to show you it works. And I'm not going to do anything with the pegs and stuff because we're staying chrome, because I couldn't change the tuners. I wanted to change the tuners to black, and I can't. So it's what it is. Next is tuning and playing. All right, we're getting ready to do the completion video on the Fender Classic 12-string with the new inlays, and that's about all. But we'll play it a little bit and show you what it sounds like.
And that's what it's about a little sunshine. Bringing a little bit of joy back into the life with music, with decorating guitars, in memorial. See y'all later. That's enough.